What's up YouTube? Welcome back to the best personal finance channel that there is out here. I hope you're having an amazing day. My name is Alexi and welcome to this channel. Today I'm gonna go into more details about my portfolio and how I make money with Trading 2 and 2, which if you don't know is the app that I use actually to invest all the money that I invest every single month. So I'm really happy I'm gonna show you every single investment that I have and what I'm gonna do with my portfolio because there is three things I wanna do with them. Some stocks that I wanna sell, some I wanna hold, and some I wanna increase over the long term, which are the ones I wanna focus the most. And I'm gonna show you everything right now. Let's go. Okay, first things that I wanna do today is show you all the investments that I wanna increase over the long term because these are probably the most interesting stocks for you. Of course, at the end of this video, I'm gonna show you all the stocks that I'm in the intent of selling and why I want to sell them. But let's start with the first one. One of my favorite holding here, and that's 3M. Well, if you never heard of 3M, first of all, it's a pretty discreet brand, but at the same time, it's pretty much everywhere in everything that you use that goes from the post-its to healthcare to transportation. They have all these sectors inside one and single company. Company that is 3M. I got two shares of them. They pay a nice dividend of 3.6%, I believe, if I remember correctly. It's a pretty expensive company at the moment, but I say that it's a really great investment if you have a really long-term view over your investments, over dividend payments and stuff like this. This company is amazing because they were able to pay the dividend and increase it over time each year for 61 years. These are one of the rare dividend kings that are out here in the market. A dividend king is when the company paid its dividend and increased it every year for about 50 years or plus, and they paid it for 61 years. It's a really good value company. So I have about two shares of them for about $320. I'm still a little bit down on the stock, but I believe that in the future they'll do just amazing. Next on the list, we have AbbVie, which is one of my favorite healthcare sector stock. At the moment, they pay a dividend of about 4.96%, which is huge, and I believe that in the future, when the stock price will go up, this dividend yield will go down a little bit, which is safer for them for the payout ratio and all that stuff. But pretty much what AbbVie does is that they are into healthcare, medication, they make a lot of drugs, and they have a big monopoly over one drug that I don't exactly remember the name, but I know it's one of the most used drugs in the world, which makes most of their revenue. It's a pretty safe company when it comes to dividend. They pay the dividend for about 8 years now, so not that great of a growth, but they plan on having that dividend payment for a long time. And there's also a lot of growth potential into this stock. At the moment, I only have one share of AbbVie, which is up quite a bit, so I don't know if I'm gonna cost average my way up into the stock. We're gonna see in the future. Then we have one of the most recent addition to my portfolio, which is Apple, which is an amazing company, and I feel so dumb that I didn't invest into Apple earlier when I started investing. I bought them like 2 weeks ago and I'm already up like 10% on the stock, which is already pretty pricey, I would say. So it makes a great return, more than $100 already in about 2 weeks, which is amazing. So Apple in the latest like 2 days were the first US company to actually reach $2 trillion of value. And they actually pretty recently announced that they were gonna do a stock split, which is something that does a lot of hype today about all those stocks, like Tesla and Apple just announced stock splits, which bring a lot of hype, so the price went up quite a bit. That's why I'm more like 10% up on the stock for now. They pay a dividend, which is nice, about 0.7% if I'm correct, and they have so much room to increase this dividend over time because they have a really low payout ratio when it comes to dividend. So in the future, I believe Apple is an amazing stock to have. I'm probably gonna buy more shares of them. I have at the moment about 2.15 shares of them, which is almost $1,000 worth, and with the 10% up that I am right now, it's already up more than $1,000. So I'm really happy with Apple and I plan on investing more into them into the future when maybe the stock price will come down a little bit. Next, one of my biggest holding again is AT&T. AT&T, they're a lot into like electronics, telecommunication, and yeah, streaming services. They have a lot of things like HBO, which are the creator of Game of Thrones, if you don't know. And this company pays a super high dividend, which I hope they will not decrease. They're one of the rare dividend aristocrats, I believe, so more than 25 years of payment at least. And yeah, AT&T is an amazing company. Right now, I believe it's a little bit undervalued because it's less than $30 at the moment, which is pretty nice. So good moment to buy AT&T, I would say. I have about 29 shares of them, which makes them, I believe, my second biggest holding, but with this high dividend of almost 8%, it's my biggest dividend paying stock in my whole portfolio. So I'm really happy with this investment. I hope that in the future, the stock price will actually go up again when this whole pandemic will kind of settle down for a little bit, but I'm really happy with AT&T. Next one, on the consumer side of my investments, I have Coca-Cola. Everybody has ever at least tasted what Coca-Cola is, And yeah, it's a pretty strong company. They have a really great dividend. I would say it's about, I think, 3.4% if I'm not mistaken. So great company, pay a great dividend. And I believe that in the future, they have so much room to grow, actually, the company with other products and other stuff to sell because, yeah, fast food and stuff like this, I believe that in the future will still be around even though everybody tries to eat healthy and stuff like this. So not really concerned about Coca-Cola. I have about 6 shares of them, which is almost $300 worth. So one big holding for me. And yeah, I really like the company. Next on the list, a bit of a controversial one because I have ExxonMobil. ExxonMobil, if you don't know it, actually, they are a lot into energy and fossil energy. So not that good of a thing. They are a lot into like gas and oil. And the problem with that is that in the future, I mean, in the long term at least, ExxonMobil will actually have to change their business into something like renewable energies and stuff like this. So they have to change their business in order for them to work into the long term. But they're already planning and doing actually a lot of research and about a lot of investments into those clean energies like the wind, and actually they're working on kind of new fuels and stuff like this. So I have a lot of hopes into ExxonMobil. I plan on holding it into the long term, and I really, really believe in them that they are able actually to take what they have and transform it into something that will be profitable over the long term. I have 3 shares of them, so that's only about $120. I'm not really putting that much money into ExxonMobil at the moment because of all the oil crisis that happened and because the stock is actually pretty down, and I just want them to keep paying the dividend, which is really high at the moment, more than 8%, so it's not sustainable. They will have to go back into business as soon as they can in order for them to continue growing. So I have ExxonMobil, I plan on adding it to the future if they start to actually do this transformation into clean energy, and we're gonna see that in the future, I guess. Next on the list, another healthcare sector stock, which is really similar to AbbVie, and that's Cardinal Health. They do pretty much the same kind of stuff. A lot of medicine, drugs, and biotech technology. They work on a lot of those things, and actually working on 2 vaccines, just as AbbVie is doing right now for the COVID, which has a lot of potential in the future, in the close future actually, to do a lot and a lot of profit. So I'm invested about 2 shares, it's about $100 worth, so not that much, because I like this company, but I believe that AbbVie, for example, is a better company into the healthcare sector, as well as another one that I will show you in the future, which is J&J, so Johnson & Johnson. They have a lot and a lot of profits that comes from drugs, and we're gonna see that in just a moment. With Cardinal Health, I have a dividend payment of about 3.7%. It's a really good dividend paying stock, so I'm gonna hold on to them and maybe increase over time. Next on the list, as I just told you, is Johnson & Johnson. A lot of healthcare sectors and a lot of consumer products too. They do a lot and a lot of things, and actually, I believe another dividend king, so they paid a dividend for more than 50 years straight and increased it over time. So really good company to invest in. I believe right now the price is actually pretty okay. I would say it's a fair to low price. So if you want to buy Johnson & Johnson, maybe consider it after this video. They pay a great dividend of about 2.7%, so it's a little bit lower than what I actually aim for in my portfolio, but it's just fine. For me, it's just fine. I love this company. You should love it too. And let's go to the next one. Oh yeah, by the way, I forgot to say, I have about 2 shares of them, which is about $300. So yeah, just letting that out here. Next on the list, Microsoft. You all know Microsoft. They do a lot of things that comes from the Xbox, PC, a lot of software too. And yeah, they make great money. It's actually one of the most profitable company in the world, I believe. And I'm up about 35% on Microsoft, which is pretty huge. The only problem with that is I only have 1 share of them. So didn't make that much profit from them, actually half from what I have from Apple with just 10%. So it's a great company. They pay a really low dividend, just as all the big tech sector company. I think it's about like 0.7, just like Apple, really similar to Apple, or more like 1%, I believe. But yeah, Microsoft, great company. If you want to invest into the far future from now, it's a great, great company to invest in. Oh, let's go back into the consumer sector with PepsiCo. Really similar to Coca-Cola, but I would say even better because they have a lot and a lot of diversification into their business with a lot of other actually products that all of you actually use every single day without even knowing that it's from PepsiCo, so the company that owns Pepsi. It's also like Lay's chips and a lot of other products actually that are really, really common, I would say, for everyone to buy. So I love this company. They also have a pretty good dividend, and I believe it's about like 3%, and I own them about 4 shares, which is like $540 at the moment. So it's a big holding for me, and I believe that PepsiCo will do amazing into the future with all the diversification they have and all the products they have. Then I'm invested into the S&P 500, so one of the ETF from Vanguard. I didn't invest that much into them, which I wish I did more, because, you know, it's the safer bet pretty much when you want to invest. If you don't know what to do, if you don't want to choose every single company that you invest in, just buy the S&P 500. It's like the 500 most traded public companies in the US. So when you buy them and the market goes up, your value goes up too. So it's really easy if you want to invest in a really passive way to buy the S&P 500 index fund or ETF. And that's what I did with this one. I have about 3 units for them, so it's only $200 invested into the S&P 500. I will probably add it into my portfolio a little bit more in the future because, yeah, it's just a safer bet. If you don't want to be stressed over your money, just do this and that's fine. Now, these are all the companies that I want to invest over the long term, and I want to increase my position to them over a really long period of time, like 20, 25, or even 30 years. So these ones are the most valuable for me at the moment. And right now I'm gonna show you actually the ones that I am planning on selling, which are the stocks that I don't really believe into the business anymore. And since right now that I know more about investing, I know that all these companies and all the sectors they're in are not actually the best buys to have, just like the company. Pretty great. So right now I have about 9 stocks that I want to sell. I know that's pretty much a lot. I did a lot of mistakes when I started investing, and if you don't want to do the same mistakes as me, just watch this and I'm going to explain why I want to sell them. First one being Carnival Cruise. Yeah, pretty much. It's really easy to explain actually. Cruise lines actually right now are down. They can't operate at all. So the stock price of Cardinal did like a yoop on the ground, and so did my money with it. I have 19 shares of them, which is less than $300. So it's big holding for me, but at the same time, it's not my biggest one. And actually my cost average on Cardinal Cruise is really low. So in the future, when they'll be able to actually open back the business and the stock price will go up a little bit, I would sell them as soon as I am in the green, which is fine for me. But you know, you always wish that the company you buy will do great in the future. I bought them just before the pandemic, so it was a bad choice for me and actually bad luck also. So yeah, I want to sell them. Exactly the same situation with Delta Airline, and it's even worse because I bought them at the peak pretty much before the coronavirus situation. They dropped down to all-time lows, and right now it's still down about like more than 25%, I believe. So yeah, Delta Airline, and I don't want to invest into airlines because I know that in the future things are not gonna work well with them, and the business model, as Warren Buffett said, is really changing right now, and airline stocks are not the best bets that you can have. Next one I want to sell is Foot Locker. Foot Locker is actually a pretty good company to invest in. I love them, and I'm actually in the green already. I'm just waiting for the stock price to go a little bit higher to sell them. And why do I want to sell them? It's just because they had to cut the dividend because of the pandemic. That's unfortunate because I wanted Foot Locker to be a big holding into my portfolio, and it's not going to be the case actually. So I'm just going to wait a little bit and sell Foot Locker. Next one that I want to sell is American Express. American Express is actually a company that I invested in without really knowing what the business is, and I still don't really know it. That's why I want to sell it, because that's a mistake that I did at the beginning of my investing journey, is that I bought company that had good statistics and that were looking good, but at the same time, I didn't know anything about them. And since I don't live in the US, well, I had no idea what the business was. And when you buy a company without even knowing what it is, it's just a bad choice to do, and you don't want to hold on to those companies. So if you did that in the beginning, that's completely fine. So did I. And that's most of the stock that I want to sell today, are stocks that, yeah, I don't really understand, or that I don't believe in anymore, or stocks that cut the dividend and stuff like this. So these are the stocks that I want to sell, and let's see the next ones. Yeah, you're gonna hate me for this because I hate myself for doing this. I invested into Moderna. Moderna is a company that works a lot with vaccines, and they had some good results with the first test they did on the vaccine for the COVID-19. And that's good news. The stock price went up quite a bit, and I was like, it's time to buy, man. No. Was not time to buy, because when you buy into hype stocks, you never know what they're gonna do in the future. So I bought at an all-time peak, then it came down, then it came back. I was like, oh yeah, I'm in the green, man, it's gonna continue. No, it came back down again. So when you invest into hype stocks, don't do it. Just don't do it, I guess. Next on the list, Kinder Morgan. I invested into Kinder Morgan just as American Express. I didn't really know what they were doing. I know it was about energy stuff and stuff like that. And yeah, don't invest in companies you don't really understand. I did it because why not? And that's a mistake you shouldn't do. The next two companies that I want to sell are actually companies that I earned from you guys by using my code. If you use the code in the description of this video and in the first comment that's pinned down below, you can actually get a free share on Trading212 that can go up to the value of $100. So amazing stuff. If you want to get free money, just open a Trading212 account and deposit $1 and you get a stock, random stock that can go up to the value of $100. So if you want to do it, just do it. And I'll also earn one. So thank you guys for using my code. And yeah, I'm just going to sell these companies because it's just free cash. So if you want to do the same thing and then invest into other companies with fractional shares, you can just do that. So thank you. And last, but definitely not least, is Wells Fargo. Oh my God, Wells Fargo. It hurts. Okay, it hurts. I'm down about 20% of them, but I have actually a lot of money invested into them. About $860 that I put into Wells Fargo because I thought that it was actually a great time to buy the company, and it was not. Because of the pandemic, I just got crushed, man. And right now I'm down about $170 onto this stock, which is really not good. And I'm just waiting for the stock to go back up and sell it. They had to slash their dividend in the latest month or so, which is really bad for my portfolio too. I just want one thing in life, just one thing. And that's Wells Fargo going up just like 20%, 10%, 15%. I don't really care. I want to sell this stock as soon as I can. It was a bad choice to invest into them. But hey, if you're interested into the content of the channel, we speak a lot about personal finance, investment, and passive income. How can you make money when you sleep and when you're working at other things, which is great. So if you want to have a lot of information about all this kind of stuff, just subscribe to the channel. I'd be really happy. It touches my heart so much. And yeah, love you guys. Go ahead and watch those two videos that are the best for you. And I see you guys in a week. Bye-bye.